Hi, I'm Mike.
And I'm Kelly. We're both engineers at the Bonneville Power Administration in Portland, Oregon.
Today we're going to show you a simple experiment that explains how electricity is used to make a motor turn.
Motors work when electricity generates a magnetic field that turns the rotor.
Okay.
Here in the Northwest, most of our electricity is made by water.
You mean hydropower?
That's right. Water flows through the dams and turns a big turbine connected to a generator. The generator makes the electricity that travels through the wires and powers our homes.
You know, motors can be big or small, but they all work on the same principle. That's electromagnetism.
So Mike, what are we doing today?
Well, we're going to build a simple motor using parts that you find around the house or at the hardware store. You'll need a highlighter, a 9-volt battery, a piece of enameled wire, a magnet, an eraser, or a block of styrofoam, two paper clips, I went ahead and straightened these ones out already, some sandpaper, and two pieces of wire to complete the circuit.
Take your enameled wire and wrap it around a highlighter or a marker.
How many times?
I'd say 10 to 15. Then once you have your coil, you want to wrap your leads. Why don't you show us how to do that?
Well, take one end of each wire and tuck it through the center of your coil. What that does is that makes the rotor for your motor. That makes a nice tight coil, and if you do that two or three times on each side, you'll have somewhat of a balanced rotor.
Then you'll want to take your sandpaper and you want to remove the enamel entirely off of one of your leads and then off just the top part of the other lead.
You mean take all the enamel off one side and then on the other, it should look like that?
That's right. So you should have all your insulation on the bottom part and then no insulation on the top part.
What you'll do is you'll take your paper clips, you'll place them in your block of styrofoam or your eraser so that they stick up. If you have alligator clips, put one to each paper clip. Place your magnet in close proximity, your coil of wire, and go ahead and energize your circuit with your 9-volt battery.
Sometimes you have to give the motor a little tap to get it spinning.
If you have trouble, maybe your magnet's not close enough, or maybe you don't have a good electrical connection because of your wire.
Yeah, try to get your magnet as close as possible to your rotor.
If it still won't work for you, try sanding to make sure you've got all the enamel off.
So make sure you do a good job sanding the enamel off of each side of your leads. So on this side, you only have the top sanded off. Yeah, most common problems are bad electrical connections.
And it doesn't matter which way you hook up the wires or how you place the magnet. Try playing with it and it'll just change the direction. So, that's it.
And that's it.
No, that's it is my line.
I know. We really like being engineers because we enjoy troubleshooting and problem solving and keeping the power flowing in the Pacific Northwest.
If you like to invent, tinker, and make things work, you too can be an engineer.
To become an engineer, stay in school, study science and math, and stay curious.
Good job on making the motor work.
All right. We like to be engineers because we enjoy... I just lost
stuff.
It. Yeah.
Peanut butter.
Run, run.
I think I pulled something.
It could be like this.
Come on, this is your Zumba.
I am so career limited now.
BPA out.